Before this episode starts, I just want to play a little video because we reference this video later in the podcast, and I feel like to the uninitiated, the podcast will sound like complete gibberish. So we're going to play the video, then we'll play the intro.
Still smoking, huh? You said you was going to quit, remember?
Shut the fuck up, I'll leave you alone.
Bro, don't start anything with me. You told me you were going to quit smoking on Monday.
Go inside or what?
I know, why would you go inside? We were buddies at Mike's. Now you're acting like you don't know me?
Get the f*** away from you, f***ing moron. You f***ing jerk off.
Hey, can you do that one more time? That was awesome.
So basically, Steve and Steven have rebranded to Goontopia, and it may not go over well with some fans.
The expression is gooning, G-O-O-N-I-N-G.
It's called gooning, and the left wants to ban it completely.
Listen, here's the thing. I love gooning.
So get up, dust off, goon.
What is up, everyone on Goontopia Nation? And I'm your host with my other host, Steve.
No, I'm Steven.
Yeah, you're Steven.
Yeah, right.
Welcome to Goontopia. I've got a story to tell you guys. So, you know, I've been hiding the secret of doing this podcast, I guess, for my parents, like it's gay sex that I have or something. And my parents were here this past weekend, Theo Vaughn, for Easter, and they found the mug to the old show. And they go, "What is this? What is Steven?" And at that point, I felt like I couldn't try to weasel my way out of it with this little AI thing or whatever. So I was like, oh, this is the name of the old podcast that I had with Steven. We have a different name now. And they go, well, what's the name of the new one? And I said, well, I don't really want to tell you because it's like goo. I can't tell you. So, and my mom goes, what's the name of it? Gay and Gayer. And at that point, I was actually a little jealous that we didn't think of that.
I mean, it would really work so well.
I know.
Because we thought Goontopia was a good take on kind of an internet show.
Yeah.
But Gay and Gayer really encapsulates the show much better.
Yeah. No, it was incredible. And then, so I told them it was Goontopia, and I had explained to them what gooning was. And that was actually not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Mm-hmm.
So I really made it about, because we have reappropriated it to just numerous screens. You know what I mean? The NASDAQ, you're gooning. If you're at a casino, you're gooning.
Yeah, we take a much broader approach to it. You know, a lot of people are narrow-minded, and apparently there's even an R Goontopia, and, mm-hmm. you know, you don't want to go there unless you want to spam about this podcast. So, you know, they don't need to know what real gooning is.
That's right. That's exactly what I was thinking, too. And that's how I handed it to them.
Oh, and speaking of goons, I had a Snapchat memory come up. You know, Snapchat's my main form of social media, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
And 7 years ago, I had a snap where I was like just sitting around being a goon.
Yeah, okay,
so
that
it's
was
been in me.
That was incredible, and that was I feel like when we bring up Nelson, he's already like a deep cut because no one else knows him. But it mm-hmm. was Nelson's dad, for any of you guys out there who may know him.
Yeah, I don't know why. I just started putting his face on everything for a while.
Well, he has this picture, and Nelson's dad is weird because he's like 70.
Mm-hmm.
And he had this picture where his like tongue is sticking out. He was a little selfie slut.
Mm-hmm.
And so that was like a great picture to just, you know, print it out on a sticker, put it on your college campus.
Yeah, well, and Nelson, the truth, I don't know. We're going to psychoanalyze his relationship with the dad. This guy you don't know, he really hates his dad.
Yeah.
But the truth is, his dad's just an old boomer, you know, and it's just who he is.
Exactly. And you know what? Old boomer, I think that's a perfect segue into this story. Ooh. Here about this old boomer. So Bill Maher, for those of you guys who don't know who Bill Maher is. No, Bill Maher was, I guess he has a few of these episodes of his podcast in the bag. The Kanye episode, apparently he has that. You were telling me about that, right?
Wait, he has a Kanye episode?
Yeah, I thought you told me that.
Oh, maybe I read that somewhere. But he definitely seems like he would have 30 of these bagged, and then he just releases them, you know, way too late.
Yeah, and so a potentially missed bag of popcorn here is Steve-O was going to be on Bill Maher's podcast. I'll pull up this tweet just to show you some text up here on the screen. But basically, Bill Maher was going to have Steve-O on when he was promoting his stand-up special. I mean, good God, Twink and Twinker here. What the hell, these guys? And Steve-O asked Bill Maher if he wouldn't smoke marijuana on the podcast, and Bill Maher said that was a deal breaker and he was not invited, allowed to go into the club random. 13 million views right there at the bottom of that tweet.
Now, what would you do? Let's say we get the call from Bill tomorrow to be on his show in 5 years when it airs. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then we go, and then he go, you know, what if he, would you sit through his smoking?
Of course.
Okay.
Absolutely.
But you're also not an addict like Steve-O. So
right.
That's the big consideration. Is Steve-O being a pussy here? Now, you told me this. He's been sober for how long, really?
16 years.
Yeah, 16 years is crazy.
This happened a few months ago, too, but this has been resurfaced again. I have a clip of him bitching about it.
I like fashion. What is that? The red glasses there in his stupid shirt.
Seriously.
Didn't him and Stav hang out at that stupid fashion show? Do you remember when Stav did that fashion show?
Was Steve-O there?
I think he was. That might be how they met.
Okay, yeah. Dude, I love what you do. You talk about sex and food, two things I can still have because it's not a drug.
Steve-O's not even like that to people, though, because Steve-O just seems dead all the time. You know, yeah. Everywhere he is, he's just like,
what? Who are you again? Yeah, that's kind of funny.
He's like half alive.
Dude, yeah, sobriety is like so important to me.
Yeah, so here's a clip of him talking about it to this guy. This guy, all you need to know about the guest is that the guest is a fan. And so,
oh, Bet David, the worst guy ever. He's not even Jewish, and his last name's Bet David.
I didn't even. David. Okay, we'll get to Jews later. Don't worry.
We have enough on them. All right.
Because for me,
late 20s, last time, mid 20s.
Yeah. I bring that up liquid death. For me, I'm a clean and sober guy.
Oh, really?
Like, it's very important that I maintain my sobriety.
How long have you been?
Approaching 16 years.
Get out of here.
Get out of my fucking van.
I'm about to be sweet 16,
bro. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And it's there's nothing, like, really, there's nothing that I value more than my sobriety. There's nothing more that I protect than my recovery. And I found it kind of upsetting when the Bill Maher podcast, which I saw you on, reached out, and they you know, his thing is he smokes pot the whole time while he interviews people, and I said, hey, I'd happily go on there, but could he, while I'm on, out of respect for my sobriety, could he refrain from smoking
pot?
He said no. That's a deal breaker.
Wow.
And Mike Tyson's.
I mean, that's crazy. I don't know, but I kind of think, you know, he's drinking the liquid death, which has got to have some estrogen in it. Is Steve-O becoming a woman is the real question. And you know what I think? I think if he went on there, he wouldn't even have the balls to smoke weed now. Like, he just seems like a pussy.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing. It's like, my initial thought is like, okay, if you've been, you know, working at being sober for 16 years and sobriety, the most important thing to you, why the fuck would you cave to Bill Maher? If I had to smoke weed with anybody, Bill Maher would be at the bottom of that list.
Also, it gives you a chance to alpha Bill by being like, oh, so you still smoke, huh?
Yeah.
Still smoke. Still smoking, yeah. Huh? Oh my god. Check in for Johnny Hamcheck later.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Still smoking, huh?
Holy fuck, dude.
Yeah. Bill's just like already sitting in his like chair, like he's just
shut the fuck up. Leave me alone.
Yo, do that again, dude.
Bill jerks off to
I'll jerk off on your face. Yeah. Alright, we're gonna have to insert the clip there, I guess, or none of that's gonna make sense. Oh, Johnny Hamcheck.
Still smoking, huh? But the thing you said about Steve-O being a woman, I'll just kind of let this play so we can get a cease and desist from Steve-O. He does kind of look like a lesbian with his cute little haircut and his cute little Warby Parker glasses. And but again, sorry, the point I was trying to make was, if he's so strong and sober, why would he like cave to Bill Maher? Like, you can't get questioned about why you're sober.
I mean, pot's got to be like the easiest one to not do. I mean, it's the most, like, it affects you the most. Like, you have to sit there and smell it.
Yeah.
But it's not like, oh man, now I need weed. It's not like a cigarette.
Yeah.
You know, like, if you've smoked cigarettes for a while and you smell one, you're like, man, I could really go for one now.
And because, you know, before you smoke a cigarette, you think, oh my gosh, secondhand smoke, it's so bad. But then once you've smoked a cigarette, you're like, secondhand smoke is like a donation. You know, you're giving.
Thank you. Thank you. This one's RFK.
And this one's Steve-O. But okay, but it's like, can Steve-O like not go to bars? Can he not see someone wearing a Budweiser shirt?
Do shows at stand up, like at clubs.
Yeah, I know.
Where people are drinking in the crowd.
Does he shut
it down?
People
are probably offering him every time, like, you know, come party with us, Steve-O.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Dude, please, please. Maybe someone just picks him up and carries him to his gay little podcast van so he doesn't get offered a drink. Because he said on like the some podcast he did so many of them to promote this gay thing. He was like, my booze bone is connected to my weed bone, which is connected to my coke bone, which is
really?
Connected to my pill bone. Yeah. And it's like, dude, that is just a little song that they sang to you in rehab because you're stupid and brain dead. Like, the weed bone's connected to the coke bone, and, you know.
Yeah, I just think he might be a mentally weak person. I mean, I just think, you know, it's like with most drugs. It's just you try them once and then you don't do it again.
Yeah.
And then if you do happen to get addicted, you quit. And then you just don't succumb to that pressure. That's all there is to it, people.
Yeah. And there's nothing glorious. And because a lot of people have been saying Bill Maher is a dick, which he is. It's like he couldn't just like take a gummy for the podcast.
That's
like,
true.
Seriously?
Yeah.
And who is this guy? No, Bill Maher's right there. What the hell were they talking about?
No. Jay Leno, everybody. Yeah. Who's Jay Leno? That's him.
Dude, Jay, who are you?
Look at his fucking uncovered feet. I hope Bet David's toes aren't out. That's not even okay.
Well, wait a minute. Is that a vape?
I'm Patrick Bet David. Well, he's like, what is he? He's a Christian.
Muslim Christian.
He is the worst.
Oh, it's a regular.
Have we talked about him at all?
No,
we haven't. We're not going to do a deep dive now, but have you watched enough of him?
Yeah.
He's just so full of shit. I don't know.
In this clip alone, I had to refrain from mentioning him because he does this whole thing. He's like, let me show you how I got Kobe Bryant on, or not the, who's he? LeBron James. Let me show you how I got LeBron James on my podcast. Let me show you how I got LeBron James on my podcast. I had set it up 1,000 iPhones that texted LeBron James. Anyway, sorry.
I wake up and I set those goals and then I follow through with my plans. Okay.
He's like a Gen X, like Andrew Tate.
Gen X Andrew Tate. Damn.
Podcast title, White Day Up, buddy.
Yo, bluff. Wait, no, that's John. I can't do Andrew Tate, so I just have to do John. Andrew Tate got banned from chess.com, I found out.
What?
Yeah, not cool, because
no,
he's the best chess player ever. I guess he lied about his like rating and stuff, which, I mean, is that surprising?
So do you think he like spammed a chat room with like the N-word or like deleted his account and just said he got banned so he could hide his chess score?
It said he was banned for violating the fair play thing, but he could have been cheating, like had a chess engine open or something.
Yeah, yeah.
He's like that Hans guy. Did you have beads in your butt? I'm Pierce Morgan. Did you have beads in your butt, Hans? All right.
Oh, wow. That's a deep cut. I remember. First thing you want to do when you play chess, do not put the anal beads in your butt. Oh, I'm Andrew Tate. Steve-O, fuck Steve-O. No, seriously, fuck Steve-O, though. There's nothing noble about being a millionaire with the resources to get sober and then walk around for 16 years thinking you're brave because you're sober. No, you're a fucking idiot. And like poor people getting sober, that's a story because they can't just go on a vacation to not think about relapsing like Mr. Steve-O can. And he's just like a huge pussy. I don't know. He comes across as a big one.
If you have the resources, that's the other thing too, because Bobby Lee's the other comedian. Well, there's all of them have their problems, but you know, Bobby Lee, he's always having to go to like Arizona or Hawaii to sober up.
Right.
I just slipped through, man. I just drank. I don't know what the fuck is going.
Oh, I have accidentally.
Oh, I have drank sake. Ooh.
Someone put sake in my shoes and sakis, and I had some.
It's just jokes, people. We're just not jokes. Making fun of Asians for real.
No. But I am making fun of Steve-O for real. And
yeah.
I also got to come in for Bill Maher at the end, though, because I mean, I'm glad that he wouldn't cave. And then I guess like Mike Tyson has like a podcast that's called like Weed the Podcast.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, but they didn't smoke weed. They accommodated me. So why wouldn't Bill Maher? It's like, it's Bill's show. You're a guest in his house, you idiot.
I just wouldn't want to be around Bill Maher, but I would do his show because it would be one wild ride. Is this, wait, whose pod is this?
I think it's Steve-O's. Okay. Yeah, because he's the van.
Yeah, because I'm on a wild ride.
I got to stay in my van so I don't relapse.
And why do they cut to the producers like they have anything to do with anything? That's the one thing in shows that drive me crazy now. I hate every producer.
This is Ben Avery's dad. I mean, that's exactly what he looks like.
It is like a more. It is like the face app of like putting facial hair and making Ben a little bit fatter or making his brother skinnier.
Yeah.
I don't know. One or the other.
I had some tips too for if anyone out there ever meets Steve-O.
Mm-hmm.
So I can check. There's some really cool stuff. So you can check this out. Like. So you can get one of these costumes here. You can make it yourself. Ooh. You can go up to him and be like, yo, Steve-O, come take me.
Ah, gotta go.
And then, you know, like you could dress up as like a giant blunt and try to go shake his hand. Mm-hmm. I thought about this because you asked me this a while back. What would it take for me to smoke weed again? Mm-hmm. If I knew that Steve-O was like within a vicinity of me, get me a cigar-sized blunt, mm-hmm. like a big Burt Kreischer cigar-sized blunt.
Oh, yeah.
Give me like 3 months head notice so I can I can train my lungs like you know how the free divers do so they can dive for like 10 minutes mm-hmm. so I can inhale and I'll balloon like a balloon mm-hmm. with all this weed smoke go up to Steve-O and be like and just blow it in his face.
Nah, I'm melting. I'm melting. I mean, what do you think's gonna happen, Steve-O? You're barely even gonna get high from that. Honestly, he would chill out and then he'd realize why he started smoking weed to begin with.
Yeah,
which is because it's relaxing.
It could help him out. It could chill him out. So
I got back pain.
Okay, then smoke some weed, Steve-O.
I don't know where my back pain came from. Anyway, we're shooting Jackass 14.
And, you know, it is interesting. The whole Jackass crew post, I guess, Jackass 2 or something. Mm-hmm. They're very interesting because, you know, you have Ryan Dunn. Who
dead.
We have nothing but good things to say about him because he died in his prime.
Yeah, and he tweeted after he was dead, which is maybe the most impressive thing I've ever seen. That's the most jackass
that
thing
is the
ever.
Best stunt, which, you know what, going on, maybe going on Bill Maher's podcast is his stunt for Jackass 7.
Mm. I'm going to sit here and not relapse.
Every day is a jackass for him. Mm-hmm. But then you have Bam Margera, who's crashing and burning at such an accelerated rate. But he's fun to watch. Mm-hmm. And we kind of feel bad for him, you know. We'll laugh, but we feel bad. Who else? Johnny Knoxville's like normal.
No, he's not.
He's not?
No, I don't like any of them because they all have the cosmetic stuff. And I mean, I guess I can't true. Blame them. They have their teeth knocked out. I guess I can't blame them for getting new teeth.
Yeah,
you know, or new
true.
Hair. But I don't know. They all look so fake and weird. And they do the podcast thing. I think Johnny Knoxville is just as bad as Steve-O.
Okay, yeah, that's a good...
He does the rounds, and he's probably more entertaining, but because Steve-O's just kind of like Eeyore.
Mm-hmm. I guess I would put Steve-O still at the bottom, but I haven't done enough research on Johnny Knoxville.
And I don't know about everybody else. I think they're probably just on Cameo. You know, like what, like what, Rob the Machine or whatever. Yeah. Rob the...
Oh, and see, look at this, Steve-O. These are chill pills, by the way. So you could take this and it would be fine.
And they're prescribed by a doctor. What, you don't trust doctors now? Yeah, they probably saved your life 10 times, Steve-O.
Dude, I got 12 boosters. That's the only thing I can be addicted to. Mm. So it's the boosters for me. You want to see me take my teeth out?
He does that on every podcast too. It takes his teeth out. Wish he'd lose an eye so he could take his eye out. That's more impressive.
Does he have BetterHelp as a sponsor? He has like the mental health thing probably.
Oh, probably, yeah.
Dude, it's helped me so much, even though I went to a real psychiatrist.
Yeah. BetterHelp helped me when my chauffeur drove me to therapy as like a pre-therapy.
There's Steve-O. I don't know. Do you have anything else to say on this? Or?
When I took the opiates, I couldn't therapy or therapoop. I don't know. Fuck you. Look, I don't know what all his problems are, but it sounds like they've been resolved many, many years ago, and he wants to live in fear, and he's missing out on hanging out with Bill Maher on the most chaotic show on the internet, and I would go in a heartbeat. So, Bill, if you want a couple of goons on, have us on.
Yeah, we will gladly accept. You know what was crazy too about this, the article about it? It was saying that Club Random is like branching out and doing like what Tom Segura does, where he buys all these other podcasts.
Oh, yeah. A young black female, Candace Owens, is probably going to go there.
You know who is on there? Kevin Garnett is going to do, it's called...
I want Brittany Venti now. How about little Brittany Venti comes on my podcast?
With her, she's black enough for me, okay?
Wait, Kevin Garnett? Wait.
KG Certified is going to be the name of Kevin Garnett's podcast.
He's on Bill Maher's. Are you serious?
Like network, yeah.
I think he has a show on like Showtime, though. That would be a weird jump like and from to go from all the smoke to all the smoke.
All the joke.
All the smoke is an NBA podcast on Showtime. So all the smoke to all the smoke.
All the joke. The other two make more sense. It's Smashing Pumpkins frontman Billy Corgan.
Hell yeah.
Why?
Love Billy Corgan, baby.
This whole time he thought he was Bill Burr. So he's like, so when you got into stand-up, you could like say whatever you wanted. Getting on stage.
What's the Smashing Pumpkins song?
The 2 Day. Like,
I love smoking a blunt and listening to that song.
And then Fred Durst from Limp Bizkit will apparently
My girl
have...
was in town this week or whatever. Fred Durst, really?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Okay.
So we got, Fred Durst, Billy Corgan, and Kevin Garnett. will be joining Bill Maher and Steve-O.
So that's Steve-O, everybody. Now we have another person, the Jesilnik Joke-off. Well, we've got. Sorry, I didn't want to spoil this segment that comes after. But we have. You have the clip, Jesilnik.
Yeah, let me. I got to airdrop it to myself.
This was Anthony Jesilnik on Harlot's Highway. Now, I don't know. This guy is so eerily familiar to me, this Harlan guy, and I don't know where I would know him from. But doesn't he look familiar?
He does.
This guy's like, how about we do some real live stand-up, boy? How about I make you dance on the fly, boy? Banana, root beer, sponge cake, a crib. How about I'm fucking a dead baby in that crib? Sorry.
Would we dare write a joke right now? Like, people watching could see it?
The art of joke writing.
Give me a premise. What do you want?
We got car crash, funeral, sex, girlfriend.
Want to combine those?
I want people to see a joke being born. I don't think anyone's ever done it.
Let's
try them all.
Okay. Let's do it, Marvin the Martian.
Last week, I was driving my girlfriend to a funeral.
That's how 99% of Anthony Jeselnik jokes just start, too.
My girlfriend.
Got into a car accident.
Ooh.
So I decided while we waited for the tow truck, let's have sex. And then the ambulance finally came and pulled me off her coffin.
His fucking buck teeth.
How about that?
Come on, guy.
I know, he's just like a,
did it.
He's like a chipmunk mascot come to life. He's like Bucky.
Yeah, he's Bucky. Yeah, that's what we know
him
from.
He's Bucky, because that was, if we'd kept driving west, that's what we would have seen. Yeah. It was what's behind him. Yeah. We would have seen the canyons and... So the comments are really crazy for this. Oh, first off, everybody's just praising this on-the-fly joke he came up with. You can see the smile.
Yeah.
Are you doing Joe Pera? You can see the smile.
You can see the smile.
I'm doing Neil Hamburger. You can see the smile when he figures it out. And just. So anyway, you can see the smile when he figures it out.
Would we dare write...
The joke... had no right to be that good that fast. Man's a comedic genius. I was reading this and I was like, people are like joking, right? But
I
knew they weren't, but it's just still that weird instinct of like, people aren't serious, are they?
I know, it's
love
crazy.
That massive shit-eating grin. Ooh, it's a shit-eating grin on your face. This is like freestyling, but for comedy. No, it's not. He said, okay, I mean, this is crazy. He said five words and then he repeated those five words back to him.
I know, yeah.
That's all it was.
He just had to like fill in with like, secondary plot points.
I know. It's like, and then it was all there for him. It's like a car, a funeral,
sex,
cemetery.
And
I was driving my car to the funeral and I went to the
my dad, Christopher Walken, was there with me. We had sex before Dune 2 was filmed. Turned out Timothy Chalamet's boy, Pussy.
It's somewhere between like Walken and a German. Yeah. That's really what it is. It's like Jesilnik, I guess, right? Is
sucked.
That German or some sort of.
Jesilnik.
And Marvin the Martian, because it's sort of. Well, how's that for a joke?
I'm Anthony Jeselnik.
He had that one I remember back in the day that was like, I was watching SpongeBob with my girlfriend, because all the jokes, like you said, start with I was with my girlfriend. I was watching SpongeBob with my girlfriend, and you know this one? And she goes, oh, where's C-Word? Where's C-Word? And said, his name's Squidward, you cunt.
And that was the whole joke.
Mm-hmm.
God. Oh, man, that is like the other guy, Joe Pera level of just stupid shit. Yeah.
No, Joe Pera's on the other side of the... Well, he's on that part of the political compass of bad.
Yeah.
But not, you know, he's like wholesome bad, which is a whole other level.
Like chaotic evil or wholesome evil, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, well, I mean, I kind of got to disagree, though. You think it's so easy? You want to try... doing some jokes right off the bat, right off the cuff?
Yes.
So here's your first premise.
With my walking. All right.
House fire, mother, car chase, and dog.
Okay, repeat those one time.
House fire, mother, car chase, dog.
I was having sex with your mother in a house fire, and the dog was licking my behind. And what was the other thing?
Car chase.
And then your pop showed up, so I had to get the hell out of there. 100 to nothing. 0 to nothing. 90 to nothing.
Incredible. Damn.
Look, I don't know. All I'm saying is I couldn't remember the words.
Do you want me to just show? Here, yeah.
No. I'm just saying you could tie anything together, and the end of the joke can just be, and then I pulled the dead baby out of the trash can, and it's like, that's fucking morbid.
Right. Yeah, it's like the anti-joke apple. Here you go. Here is your second premise.
Oh, and then she was 12, and that's how the joke ends. You know, it's like, oh, and I was with the girl, and she was 12.
And by the way, the retard is who I fucked.
Oh, and by the way, she showed me a Down syndrome certificate.
Oh, man. So here's your second premise here. Okay. We got handgun, mm-hmm. concert hall, sex, and Joe Pera.
It was Mr. Green with the handgun in the concert hall. I'm playing Clue now. Yeah, I don't know. Having sex with Joe Pera's dead ass cheeks. While they listen to Bubba O'Reilly. And that'll all make sense later. I don't know. I guess I wasn't as good at this as I thought.
No, that one's good. I like how you did a Clue spin on it.
I put the handgun to my bitch's mouth, in her mouth, rather. She wouldn't shut up at the concert hall where we were having sex with Joe Pera, a three-way.
And Joe Pera wasn't even performing.
Woo.
Premise three, we've got...
Do you want to do this one? I mean, it's your list, but we'll just pretend like...
I'll take a crack.
I wrote three. Okay. I wrote premise three.
Looks like Casio, like the watch, casino, banana. Okay, don't mind if I do,
yeah,
George
Floyd.
Yeah,
I gave you the fucking layup. This is an alley-oop. Okay. Premise four better be good, damn it. Okay, go ahead.
The fourth one, that's the best one.
All right,
one.
You take a crack, and then I'll take a crack.
All right. At the banana casino. Mm-hmm.
It's shaped like a casino.
Banana. There stood a George Floyd trying to cash out with his farts. Mm-hmm. All right, you want to take this?
I was going to say, you know, a lot, you know, they always mention, when you die, you poop yourself. And it's like, really, that's the first thing you're going to think about after 8 minutes of watching that?
Yeah. He's got to fart first. Man, imagine like death scenes in movies if they depicted that.
Imagine us robbing a casino with banana guns. Oh, it's George Floyd who farting. Beat us to robbing it first. So we farted on him. Okay, I don't even know what this segment is anymore. I'm so sorry.
This is good. This is great.
I don't know how he devolved to walk and you just...
Because that's how Anthony Jizzle...
I need to hear him again. Just play him for a second.
Yeah.
Write a joke right now. Like,
let's do it.
See it.
Give me a
let's
premise.
See, let's see what we come up with.
Let's see what we
give
come
me,
up
give
with.
Give me a premise.
Sort of Marvin the Martian, but a little bit lower.
And like sex, Elon Musk.
But then he becomes Jewish.
I want people to see.
He's like, yeah.
A joke.
Walking and Musk.
Come on.
Okay.
Last week.
This other guy's so happy to be doing
this. I was driving
this.
My girlfriend to a funeral.
I said it's Rick Glassman and Guy Fieri together.
Yes.
So
excited about
Let's have sex.
Let's have sex.
And then...
That shit-eating grin, as the comment says.
I'm so happy
to tell this sick joke.
What do you think about that?
Honestly, it didn't even make sense to me the first time I heard it. I had to watch it a second time. Now, I might be stupid, but the truth is... Offer coffin. You know, it's like offer coffee pot. You know, sort of the imminent thing.
That's an awful hot coffee pot. Offer sot, top of jock.
Awful hot baby to fuck on the coffee pot. Right. I mean, I don't know. It's really just the lowest level of like the most fucked up thing you can think of. And yeah. I think we do that sometimes, but we like to punch you with it, like a quick punch in the mouth. And then we pull away.
Exactly.
And we go, did they just say that? Did they just say that thing about, what did we say about Asians earlier?
They all
can't drive because of the slants. You know, like, dude, I've had an Asian friend.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've loved an Asian woman.
Look.
Allegedly.
That's how I make a point.
What was I going to say about
premise
this?
Premise four.
Before I bring it up, premise shake. You know, like grimace shake, premise shake. Okay, so here we go.
The
so we've got...
shake I shoved in her face. Freestyling. Yeah. That's like freestyling with the jokes.
Yeah. I mean, it's like they're doing Mad Libs, you know? And then, but the Mad Libs are predetermined. So there's no... They're like just filling in the non-ad-libbed fun part of ad libs.
It's sort of how we just like fill everything in with N's and F's and R's all day.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like we really don't have to put any thought into it. And that's sort of the beauty and the easiness of life for us is that we just replace any other word with an F, you know, or an N. Okay.
And they put together like a first grade sentence and they're like, whoa, I hate that awesome. So we got Palestine, Israel, detention, and bubble gum.
Bubble.
Buggles. Well, it was supposed to be bubblegum.
The Buggles.
I heard you on my penis back in 52.
Yeah, the Buggles or whatever.
You were in Palestine and Israel too.
Giving detention to those awful rotten Jews.
Oh, oh. We chewed some bubblegum. Oh, oh.
Oh, man. Israel killed the media. Okay, no. That's terrible.
Damn, we're going to get banned. We're going to get canceled for these fucking sick, twisted jokes. Pulled me off her coffee pot.
Off her coffee.
We were in Palestine, which was in Israel.
What was the thing you said? Sorry, like 20 minutes ago, the fucking Steve-O smoking again.
Still smoking, huh?
Oh my
god, Hamcheck.
I know, that's too funny.
Holy shit. Okay,
you'll understand someday, my child. As yes. Robin Williams says as she wipes a wee tod. Now we can go to the regular jokes segment.
Ooh.
Do you have a joke to read?
No, I don't. So, per usual, you are prepared.
Okay. I will. This one's really bad, so it's. I won't read it. No, I'll read it. It was just that Kesha's, it's not as fun with the note cards. Kesha's song, TikTok, have changed the lyrics to the intro of the song. Have you heard about this? Have you seen these guys before?
Mm-mm.
Now it's wake up in the morning due to the recent events.
Oh, shit. Hadn't even thought of this.
Wake up in the morning feeling like Polanski.
No, so, she changed to Polanski?
I know. Someone tell her. And then... So this other one, you do it in the Michael Eric Dice Clay voice. You go, this Sam Bankman-Fried is in jail. Yeah, that's right. They ought to call him Sam Brokman jailed. That's all I had. So.
I go, he's Diddy. He can't be that bad, or he'd be King K. Rool.
Oh, there we go.
The bad guy from Donkey Kong.
The Sam P. Diddy. Diddy what? Did he what? That was a weird voice that changed. Yo, dude, P. Diddy. Diddy. He did not. Okay. Steve-O to RFK Jr. That's a hard... Mm-hmm. I can't make them sit in a room to talk to each other, which is what RFK Jr. has been saying this whole time, that the country would get along, but he can't sit with Steve-O.
If RFK goes on Steve-O, I'm rescinding my vote, even though we have not officially given out the Goontopia vote yet. Or, mm-hmm. We have not declared our vote. I know last week I said that.
Yeah.
That we were voting for RFK, but you're right. We have to hold off.
Mm-hmm.
We have to wait till the dust settles. See if these fuckers debate.
Yeah.
But if RFK goes on Steve-O's podcast and he's like, oh, you're the only one giving me a platform. Wow, dude. I love that. What? Huh? Dude, look up really quick. This will be worth it.
Okay.
On YouTube. Abe's Odyssey talking. It was a video game on PlayStation 1. And the way they talk is, yes. Dude, this is literally Steve-O. Yes. Oh my God, this is gonna blow. No, wait, no, not him. He's the main character. Okay. Well, let's see. Hold on, see if he sounds.
Hello.
No, it's not him.
Okay.
Is it gonna be
shit,
someone?
Maybe it's the bad guys in the game. Okay, play level one.
How about that one?
Okay, yeah. But could be it. Yep, this is him.
Hi. Here, boy. Great. Get him.
That's Steve-O.
Yeah, no, that is exactly Steve-O.
He voiced this character. I'm not joking.
I know. Well, that sounds exactly like him. No, that's not him.
Yeah, that's RFK, though.
Hey, come here.
So, Abe's Odyssey, one of the worst platformers ever.
I think I remember you telling me about this like a while ago. That's a deep cut, as we all say.
Mm-hmm. I'm full of them. We've done our bit now. We've tried to be funny. We've shown our comedic chops today, but we have somebody who's really funny who definitely doesn't rely on shtick, if you know what I mean. Alex Edelmen is he's got a special coming out on what, HBO Max?
Yep.
And it's called I'm Jewish and I'm Proud.
For us.
But my mother's not, because every Jewish mother and her brother and your sister is about making
making them. Why? Because, which, should we play that? Should we show the trailer?
Do you think we can? I don't even know it gets cut any, or like
I don't either.
Okay,
we'll play a little bit of it, and because I got something to say about his mic.
I grew up in Boston. I grew up in this really racist part of Boston called Boston.
Bow, bow. Has anybody ever said that before?
Yeah.
Do you want to come with me to this meeting of Nazis in Queens?
The sky.
Dude, those fucking cuts of him like,
privilege more than a Jew walking into a meeting of racists and thinking, this will probably be fine.
He has the Britney Spears headset on so he can do the gritty.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he ends it with. Oh, why?
Because it's about making my father and my sister and my mother happy.
What is this, a chair? How about we all share? There's two of them now? What the f-
Yeah. They always say a chair is just a table with a back. Well, where's the back? Is it a table now or what? A really small table.
Man, I think this just goes to show how fucking easy freestyle rapping joke edition is, mm-hmm. and two, observational comedy.
Yeah.
You just gotta go like this.
Well, most of what he talks about in it is like, my dad is like a physicist or cured cancer or something. Mm-hmm. My mom is never proud of. No, he made a fake heart. He made an artificial heart, yeah. And he almost won the Nobel Peace Prize. And my mom's like, it took.
Shot live and live it LA this week. It's a good show.
Can someone help with that song that's playing in the background? It's called Shazam. I know you can't Shazam it when he's talking the whole time, when he's flailing on stage. Mm-hmm. When does it get funny? The last part seems true. What was the last part?
I don't know. He's gay.
Jewish.
Yeah. Jewish. In case you didn't know, I'm Jewish. When does
and
the
and like
funny
every
start?
Good Hanukkah we had guilt. I don't know.
Just watched you on Adam's show. You know whose show he was on? He was on Rick Eisen's. Rich Eisen? Is it Rich?
Wow.
It's got to be Rich, right? Because he's
yeah,
Jewish.
Rich.
Okay, Rich. Yeah. Yeah. I'm Rich Eisen.
Do I look like a Rick to you?
Pickle Rick, maybe. I don't know. Should we even talk about... What do we have to say about Joe Pera other than we fucking hate him?
I mean, can we show Bubba O'Reilly? Probably not.
No, no.
I don't understand the line, though. That's also on Max.
Well, it's the song. The fact that it's
okay,
a song.
Can we mute it?
Yeah, yeah.
Joe Pera is this comedian who apparently has a pretty big following, a big enough following, but somehow. And he was on Adult Swim, I guess, about 4 years ago is when that was uploaded. Mm-hmm. So like 4 years ago to like 2 years ago. He was on for probably three-ish years.
Mm-hmm.
And he did Joe Pera Talks With You. And then before that, he'd done like Joe Pera Talks You to Sleep or something. And so his whole shtick is that he's like a grandpa and he has all these old person tchotchkes, like he's your grandparents. I don't know. He's into stupid shit. And now in this clip, he's going to hear Bubba O'Reilly by The Who for the first time ever, which again, that doesn't make sense because he would already listen to boomer music based on his character.
That's true. That's a good point.
I don't get it. So unless he listens to like a 1930s, like,
there's that negro, watch his negro, that's an awfully odd coffee pot.
Yeah. Picking God now, man. Okay, so, yeah, that's about it. I don't know. So,
let's just jump in.
WKUP, you're on the air. What was that song you just played?
What was that song you just played? I gotta sound like a stupid asshole.
Yeah.
But talk even slower.
Got it.
What are you, Malone there? What am I, Neil Hamburger?
Okay. Well, the name of this song is Bubba O'Reilly. Write a song that good, you can give it whatever dumbass title you want.
Okay.
Okay, Bubba O'Reilly.
The name of the group is The Who. All right? The
Who. Say that again? The
Got
Who?
That down so we don't get
John?
Again, yeah. What? What was that? Right. The what?
Thank you very much.
The Who?
The Who?
Could you please play it again?
Absolutely.
So then he goes on and he calls every radio station in town. Uh-huh. And one of the comments too pointed out, it's like, I love how he knows all of the phone numbers to all the local radio stations.
And it's like he'd use a phone book.
Yeah, it just didn't show that, okay? Yeah. But the main thing is it's just some corny, cornball, boring shit. And he gets excited about Bubba O'Reilly, dances around his house.
Yeah.
And I guess I don't know what emotion I'm supposed to feel, like uplifted. That's why I said it's like Wes Anderson, where I watch a Wes Anderson movie. I'm like, how am I supposed to feel?
Yeah, yeah.
Uncomfortable watching somebody else have an emotional thing happen to them.
It's like Wes Anderson minus the symmetry. You know who he really reminds me of?
Hmm.
Actually, here's a question I'm going to pose to any of you that are fans of this cornball, as you said.
Mm-hmm.
How is he any different from Bert Kreischer? What is Bert Kreischer's shtick to take his skirt off? And this guy's shtick mm-hmm. is to talk like an old man and slow and boring. And oh, it's funny because he jumped. Old Charlie Bucket from the 70s movie jumped up and down and he talks slow, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing. He's a one-trick pony, but in our book, that makes him a full-time phony.
Yeah, and that was good.
Thank you.
That was really good.
The bells just killed me.
Yeah, somebody did make that comment too, where they're like, the bells, the jumping... The pizza guy. I mean, like, the ending of this segment should be that he fucks the pizza guy in the ass.
Yeah. Well, I thought, because we were talking about this yesterday, we were watching this yesterday.
Like, it'd be so funny if through the window you saw the shot of him having sex with him. Then that would, like, make it all worth it. It's like, this guy just called every radio station, he can't stop listening. And then that's, like, him post-cum.
Yeah, yeah.
Just, he's, like, eating, and he's like, get out. Get out of my house.
Get the fuck out of here, Sam.
That would be so funny.
No, it totally make the whole sketch worth it, because he'd be like, oh, he looks like a gentle old man, but then he just raped the pizza man.
Or, here's a deep cut, he just is a crippled pizza delivery driver, and he goes, custom made just for you.
That's your pizza.
And then he becomes, yeah, then he turns into the bully, where
I'm gonna fucking pick up my fucking ears, man. I'm throwing you on the stairs or whatever he says.
So that's all the show is. There's one where he's supposed to be reading the announcements at church, and he just gets sidetracked, and he talks about, he's like, have you ever tried a bagel with chives on it, you know?
Dude, that is the, I'm sorry. Did you see that video that came up? It was a suggested of Joe Pera with Anthony Fantano. That's the nightmare blunt rotation right there. Good gosh, Steve-O. Oh, man.
Wow. That would be the most disengaging, or whatever you'd call it, because they would not be engaged with one another.
Like, no.
Joe Pera would be like, sure. Oh, I'm just happy. He'll do like little smiles too, like he's just happy to be talking to someone. It's like, come on.
Dude, shut the
You're a grown man. But the main thing is the show's boring and it's not funny, and he doesn't do anything other than talk like that.
Yeah.
And it's like Reddit brain. And Sam Hyde recently is like, he kind of made fun of him. You sent me the clip again. Yeah, I rewatched it. And Sam was like insulting this guy. But then he goes like, it's still impressive to be. I'm trans Hyde now. My voice is gone. It's still impressive that he has 500 people captivated. It's like, no, it's not. Like, it's a million Reddit brains out there. You can get 500 in a room.
Right.
And do Reddit humor, which is what he does. And were you going to show any of the stand-up, or can I just explain that it's...
Do you want to explain it, or you want me to
show it? He just reads from a fucking piece of paper the whole time. Well, 20 pieces of paper.
I mean, the whole special is the same, so we can literally start anywhere.
Show the door thing. This is... How about that door?
Dude, this is fucking gay.
I worked with that door and it raped everybody it ever saw. Like, that would be the funny joke to say about the door. Look at that bastard door thinking he can be so big. Look at that door back there. He's so damn big. He thinks he can just walk around here.
How about this door?
How about this door?
It, like, standing O.
You know what it is? People hear that and they go, I'm so smart. I get the subtlety of him not having to say very much and just say the fucking thing of like, shilly me. Oh, aren't I speaking in a funny manner?
Okay, that, you know, that is perfect. Because on the way over here, I was listening to this, like, ready to, like, run anyone over. And I was trying to figure out what it was about this that I hate. And that is exactly it. They think that there's some, like, subtext or deeper meaning, feeling like they're part of an inside joke.
I know.
But it's like, this is Bert Kreischer level stupidity of retarded humor.
I'm telling you, I could write this guy's jokes for him. I watched him for 20 minutes. Or I probably watched 30 minutes of this, but it was at 2x speed. And it's like the kind of joke he would write. He's like, I brought out 2 waters because I know I'll get extra thirsty when I talk. And everybody would erupt laughing just because he explained that he might need more water than the average person. I mean, it's crazy.
It's like they laugh as if Sheldon is saying bazinga. It's like that level.
It kind of is on the same level. And maybe it's the nerd thing too.
I want to take a crack at his thing real quick. I like paper because you can shave your words onto the ermi gersh. See, you delve into Neil Hamburger and I delve into the ermi gersh and retarded.
Yes.
Okay, here we go.
Let's do comedy.
Yeah, there we go.
You came because for a couple hours you don't want to think about the potential for nuclear war.
But holy if you do get blown up,
want to be amongst 600 people who find similar things funny.
How is that a joke?
It's really like they're being told to laugh.
I know.
It's like so on command.
And when I'm done speaking the end of the sentence, you'll laugh.
Jump kind of more to the middle and just see how he's still relying on these on this paper, and let's just see. Okay. Oh, the dating column is crazy. I went on a date with a lawyer. And I told her I just was happy to be at Costco that day, and she told me she works long hours, and I said I had a dentist appointment,
which is why he's a pedophile. Smoking again, huh? Gay, hope you're smoking gay cigarettes.
Gay cigarettes. Folks, if you are a smoker, if you're not a smoker, become a smoker, because gay cigarettes is the greatest cigarette you could possibly smoke.
Still smoking gay cigarettes. This is a disaster.
This is terrible.
Nobody knows. This is like fucking combining six things together.
Well, I'll do a. Trust me, I'll do this. I'll fix it in post.
You have to put in that Hamcheck video just because none of it will make sense.
Still smoking, huh? Hope it's gay cigarettes. We've been recording for 4 hours, by the way, and we've still stuck on the still smoking. Okay, here is his dating column.
Well, they tried to claim metaphysical properties as well, like gravity. They'll try, she said. She's probably right. But the casual way she said it made me no longer hungry for my drink.
Dude, somebody said that it's like a new form of art. There's like, it's like a new art form. Because you could fall asleep to it or something. Yeah. I was like, what?
No, he is the Bob Dylan of stand-up comedy because he's so fucking boring and he sucks.
But everybody thinks he's good.
Yeah.
There ain't no use to shit and wonder why.
Somebody told me that it was back in blue.
Yeah, he's like Joe Biden. Yeah.
Victory.
Victory. Somebody once told me.
I mean, get this guy reading a Smash Mouth lyrics and the Redditor audience will kill themselves with laughter.
Dude, that is like the kind of stuff he'll drop in. He does drop in a TikTok reference. He's like the kids would be on TikTok. Oh. And everybody goes, fuck yeah, Joe. You're so funny. You're so funny, Joe.
There you go. My cousin Vinny. Let's hear this.
Got a lawyer like my cousin Vinny.
I mean, for fuck's sake, people, it's kind of like Pepsi Cola.
Like my big fat Greek wedding.
My big fat Greek wedding.
She told me it was an illegal alien, which I presumed was some sort of otherworldly creature.
I said, who's an alien? Who's a popular fucking alien? Shit.
You mean Marvin the Martian?
Yes, there we go. I said, hi, Marvin.
Anthony Jesilnik.
Pleased to meet you, Martian.
I mean, this guy was holding his face. You're looking on the left side, tattooed bald. He's got to put his face in his hand because this was so fun. You want to go to We'll do. I want to see kind of what his closer is.
They say within 10 years, all vehicles will be electric.
He's just doing Joe Rogan stuff.
Stand-up comedy will fully move to Austin, Texas in the next few years.
They say the vaccine changes a protein-inducing part in your DNA.
Living in crazy times. It's crazy out there.
What's the guy?
Cat Williams said, I ain't never been no funny and that I was just a honky ass cracker.
I'm a honky.
Let me see what.
DH through your head and music. Then the rest of your body as well. As it melts, your worry does too. It's magic, you say.
It's like being a kid again.
No, says Yubi.
Yubi? What is this, Sam Hyde's Yuri's Big Adventure or whatever the fuck? Yubi.
I'm glad to be in a relationship with you.
The name's Yubi. Yubi Soft. I make games like Assassin's Creed. I don't know.
I told you this, but it's like, this is something that, you know, when you meet up with a friend after spending a year in like a university, like a friend from high school, you're catching up and you're kind of showing each other like your new videos. Mm-hmm. And like, I would show them like Sam Hyde videos, like, oh, look at this guy like harassing people for real. If someone showed this to me, I would never talk to them again. Is that right?
Yeah, I mean, and I did show it to you.
Well, you did it for the same reason.
I'm doing Coachella this year, I said. And they said, that's for music, dummy.
And I said, I'll make my own damn music.
What is this door made for a giant?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't see any magical beans backstage.
I would presume
there would be a giant beanstalk leading from this door or from behind this door.
This door is if you took all the women that Robin Williams raped and stacked them up, they could go through that door.
It's like,
Yeah, the Neil hamburger might be the most lost part of this.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all right.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Oh, okay. So that is Joe Pera, everybody. His show sucked. He sucks. But he's really maybe one of the worst. I can't even like angrily watch him.
No.
Okay. I think we can breeze through everything.
Okay.
We just got to be tight about all this. So all first right. We got Shohei Ohtani. Now, this is a total deviation from everything we've been talking about, sports.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Shohei's the best baseball player in the world, and he had a translator who was betting, and that's the story anyway. So they found out that he had bet like $4.5 million.
Uh-huh.
And now there's going to be a whole investigation into it. But the problem is Shohei doesn't speak a lick of English, and everything he's ever said has come from that translator's mouth.
Hmm.
So now we're like, can we get another translator? And then it's like, can we trust that translator in a court of law?
Okay.
I mean, I'm more making it complicated as a joke, but...
But I gotcha. Because he could be like, Your Honor, he clearly just said he doesn't even know what... and this is how he pronounced it, guys. Gambering? He doesn't know. he pronounced it like that in Japanese.
Somebody came out in the defense. I don't know if it was like his team or like lawyer or whatever that was like, he doesn't really follow other American sports. And then there's like a photo of him wearing like an NBA hat or something.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
So, but he's the most incredible baseball player. So I hope nothing happens to him or they make some crazy exception.
He's not killing anybody, you know?
He is so incredible. And I'm not even the biggest baseball guy, but he's so good at pitching. He's so good at batting. He's good at both.
That's crazy.
It's a rare thing.
A double whammy. We call that a double whammy here. So Babe Ruth 2. This whole time, I was kind of trying to think, how can I make a joke about like trans? What'd you say, translator? So it's like his current identity, but he's going to be translator and then play. When he's trans, he gambles. When he's translator, he's the baseball player. So it's two different identities. I couldn't piece it together. So.
Hey, yo, what do you mean I need a translator?
Yeah.
You tell me, come my dig up, boy.
All right. Yeah, we've got Tyler Perry.
Yeah, okay. So we got, Wow. Tyler Perry's Romeo and Juliet. I love that. That's
coming
very
out.
Funny.
Also, real quick, I want to say about this account saying they are rewriting history. Romeo and Juliet is a fiction. What do you mean rewriting history? Which also, this movie, I can't get away with. Have you seen this one?
Yeah.
This, where it's like, I doth do point thy 9mm at my fellow wigger. Like
yeah,
that.
I hated that part of it.
Yeah.
Claire Danes, and I don't care what anybody says, and here's the thing. She might have been 17, so we might just cut that. I don't know.
Okay.
But look, I mean, you put that next to the beautiful European beauty next to fucking, I mean, that looks, I don't know. I was really trying to come up with something.
I mean, I understand the killing yourself part, but I'm lost at the killing yourself over her because you love her. I thought it was like, here's your arranged marriage is this lady. Now I'll kill myself.
Are they going to do what you think a modern take on this, or they're just going to have this be historically inaccurate?
I don't know. That's a good question. But I also, you know, I want to say too, I don't think Tom Holland is a good Romeo guy. He looks like he's younger than Juliet, and Juliet's the young one.
Yeah, she doesn't look young enough. Juliet should be a child, but you know.
Julia child, that's where she came from.
Yes. But yeah, I don't know, kind of predictable casting at this point. You know, I don't know. I'm just sort of tired of Tom Holland and what's the other guy?
Zendaya. Oh, Timothy.
Well, their little love triangle
that
always happens in every movie. I don't know.
Also, I feel like it is kind of gay to get mad about this. It's like, oh, what, your gay little love story is now ruined? Mm-hmm. But it's like there's so many different versions of it. And
it's like, haven't we been trying to prove that we don't need Shakespeare this whole time?
Yeah.
Wasn't Shakespeare racist or something?
Yeah.
Isn't that what they've been saying and out?
And also... there's that theory that if you let a monkey type on a typewriter forever, forever, they will eventually write out the works of Shakespeare, which just shows how easily repeatable his crap, dare I say crap, is.
Yeah, well, I'm glad that's the point you made, and it's an excellent one.
And also,
if you give a pig a pancake, if you give a chimp a typewriter, you might just get cast in Romeo and Juliet as the lead. That would be funny if it's like, no, she just was the first female cast in it. She's actually their slave.
Yeah. Yeah. Juliet, what are you, crazy?
Yeah.
Hey, yo, white boy, come on over here, boy. I do be biting my thumb at thee.
I'm just trying to come up with a black version of Juliet. Yep.
Let me see. Let me pull up like Juliet like quotes.
Here we go.
How about Romario and Julie, Julie Waluigi? Juliet Waluigi. Romario and Julie Waluigi.
Romario. I just... I got the... Romario and Julia Waluigi. Jeez. Shit, my love sprung from my only hate. Too early seen unknown and known too late.
Wow, they do sound like rap lyrics. Yeah. She's going to be rapping this.
Well, that makes sense now. I get the casting choice.
I feel like this segment's going poorly.
Okay. No, we can dump out of it. It's either, if it's not going...
It's so racist.
Yeah, if it's not going poorly, it's the most racist thing we've ever done on the show, hands down. So...
All right. Now, an easy enough segue. Monkey.
Speaking of
monkey Instagram.
Guys, check out, this is a little quick breakaway video.
So I will say, this may be animal abuse. I don't know how to feel about it.
That's what
Well, I've given my thoughts that I think this is, this flies in third world places.
Yeah.
And Arabs love animals.
And this is just any other teen getting a haircut.
Hola, Jimmy, hola.
I love his eye, the monkey's eyes, how they look around.
Love, you'll see it at the end, you know, because he does the right cheek trim up there, left cheek trim up, and then when he does underneath, the monkey's mouth opens. Mm-hmm. His eyebrow, yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah, no, this isn't so bad.
Oh yeah, I mean, he's doing well. I mean, the clippers are loud, you know what I mean? It's just getting at his face. I know,
but it's then like when they turn the camera off, they just like beat the shit out of this monkey. Yeah. Or something. It's like, that's what the fear always is. Damn, monkeys rule.
I know.
Damn, I'm screaming about Joe Pera to this. I love it. It's beautiful.
It's calmed us down.
It really shows you. You know, they always say autistic people like animals more. It's like they just get along with the animals better. Mm-hmm. Do you ever feel like that's a quiz on an autism thing? It's like, do you feel like you get along with animals better than people? They're like, oh, 100%. Yeah. 100%.
I don't think that's a sign of autism, though. You know, it's like, that's got to be
everybody.
Yeah, because
horse girls are always kind of ass pies.
Yeah, but that's only horses, not animals.
But that's a subtyping of
it.
Vet people kind of are sometimes.
Yeah.
It takes a lot to not care about humans and to care way more about animals. I mean, that's almost feels like it should be a sign.
No, I get what you're saying. That makes sense. And I feel like you do kind of have to be a little off to prioritize an animal over a human. But I mean, but when the monkey's doing this so darn well at his haircut, it's kind of hard not to. His hair grew back fast, too. I'm just kidding. It's looped. It's done a little loop-de-loop.
Yeah, maybe that guy should get some arm hair removed. Maybe he needs to stop harassing this monkey.
Well, the camera zooms out and it's another monkey cutting the monkey's hair, actually. So.
Yeah, that's like a Xavier, ridding an angel.
Who cuts the monkey's hair? Monkey. Monkey see, monkey do. Ooh. Cut his hair.
Monkey goo.
While he attacked me.
He always like fizzles out, Xavier. So from one monkey haircut to another monkey's haircut. I don't know. That has to be the... We got Seinfeld with the hair transplant. Now, this is crazy. This was in honor of Easter. That was what the caption was on this very funny tweet. This Easter... You got Jerry Seinfeld from a year or two ago, totally fucking bald, missing all of his hair on top. And then now we've got the hair restoration in full force.
Just came back
out of nowhere. And you were skeptical of this. Yeah, and I think you should explain it because I think the audience may also be skeptical. And people, I know that I'm leading this charge. Mm-hmm. Why are you so damn? Is it just because you're going bald? Is it just because you're ugly that you're worried about? I just want people to know this is happening instead of thinking... Jerry Seinfeld is handsome.
Yeah.
At fucking age, whatever.
And they should be open about this stuff too. Like Matt Rife. Hey, nice jawline. Yeah, I got the metal chompers installed.
Yes.
If they were open about it, no problem whatsoever. They have to lie. But okay, so I was skeptical about it just because, well, you pointed this out. This was part of your outrage about it, is that Jerry Seinfeld seems like a guy who just ages. Why would he put makeup on? Why would he do
any... I don't care.
Yeah, yeah.
What do I care? I'm just getting old.
This dude wears like suits and Skechers. He thinks that's like a good outfit choice. Mm-hmm. So that makes sense. And so, yeah, I don't think he'd get the surgery. But this picture, I feel like they're kind of at different angles. And also, I don't know, his hair is longer in that one. So it's also like if he just didn't cut his shaven or his bald head, it could look like that. So we had to do some further digging to conclude.
There is something that will prove this conclusively.
Yeah. And I've got actually a video of him from his old hairline too, just to kind of compare.
Okay, great. I was actually going to show you. Okay, yeah, do that. And then I was going to say we should pull up the in between, which it's not really an in between, but we should pull up that him on what's his Kyle Rittenhouse's podcast. Yeah. What's that guy's name?
Kyle.
Done again.
Yeah. He's done again. And by the way, everyone talks about this show, this stupid Michael Richards.
Okay, so we're painting a picture in your head now. You all remember Seinfeld. Jerry had great poofy fucking hair. Here's years after, and you can tell that it's going away. You know, he cannot possibly grow it as thick up top.
Right.
You can tell it's getting a little weaker up front. You can see the top of his head starting to show.
So we'll go, and then we'll go to that. You say Kyle Dunnigan?
Yeah, because I think we're going to be able to get a really good side angle to prove his baldness. And then when you see the Pop-Tart movie.
Yeah, then that's going to be the full.
I mean, this motherfucker is bald.
He didn't even try. Oh, my gosh. Then we've got the.
Yeah, you said, what would it look like if it grew out? It'd be like that.
Yeah, no, that's a very good point. And Sylvester Stallone, and all I do are impressions of my impressions. I would hang out with Joe Pera because I'm also a fucking fan.
Yeah, okay, can you do a faster and then just see if he ever turns his head to the side? Because I really would love a...
He looks like Eric Butts there with his like quick moving.
I'm a kid. They may have the same type of tism. Look at me when I'm young. That's the first example.
That's pretty damning. I mean, even just there, he's showing you the full range. Like, it doesn't go that far out here, but we'll keep holding out.
I'm getting worried, though.
He won't turn to the side.
No, I'm getting more worried that I'm not going to be validated or something.
No, I think this is...
Yeah, because it's so full up top in that movie. Okay, I don't know, because he does have a... I don't know. Okay.
Are we ready for the Pop-Tart?
Yeah. That's going back to the middle of his fucking head. Put your cursor... Oh, see, I'm making you go back. You're good.
Okay. And so we got the Pop-Tart, the movie. Why? Because life is all
about...
It'd be
way funnier if Larry David did it, though. Yeah. Because then it'd be like, what? I wanted hair.
I don't know. I wanted a fucking toaster pastry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, oh, Bill Burr's the president.
Dude, I'm JFK. My fucking nephew's going to run for president. Cheated on my wife? Yeah, with a black lady. What is next? The Hot Pocket? Cuts to Jim Gaffigan.
Can't wait for the Hot Pocket.
That wasn't it. It was the picture. It's like whenever the...
Oh, was that...
No. It's like they take a picture.
It's him with her. Yeah, there you go.
That is a good one.
This motherfucker. And look, the other thing too is I think people, when you hear it's like, no, because look, you can still see it's not totally full up front. Yeah. It's like, dude, if they fixed it totally and he looked like he did at age 30, it would be weird.
Right.
It would be unnatural to the eyes. We've got used to old Jerry.
And I think this is a good angle too, because it just shows, like, that's way too straight. You would have to see the curvature of his baldness, mm-hmm. as was seen when he was on Kyle Dunnigan's show. And there's one more, since we did get the main one, but let me see if the other one is that Bill Burr burning himself on the fucking Pop-Tart?
Bill, damn, this cast.
I know. Well, that was too. Dude. What can I say? And he's in makeup too. He's gone back on this. I don't know if he ever said he wouldn't wear makeup, but to me, it just seems like somebody who wouldn't. What is there to make up? I'm making up nothing. I'm the real deal, motherfucker.
I'd rather make out with young girls.
Yeah. I'd rather make out with Juliet. So there we go. Jerry Seinfeld, he's on bald watch here. So he's on our bald man watch. When you get that surgery, can the balding can come back.
It can. You have to get it again. Like, Dave Portnoy's already done it twice.
What's the guy? Bob Odenkirk, super bald. When he was on Tom Green's show in the early 2000s, he said he had just gotten the anti-balding surgery, and it's back even worse. But
Wait, when did he do that, though?
When did he first do the surgery?
Yeah.
In, like, the early 2000s.
Okay, well, that's when it was still jank and shitty, and people go, okay. Oh, you're getting hair plugs?
Gotcha.
Like, because people either get hair plugs, or I don't know the exact distinctions, but... And then the other was people get, like, their back hair. Like, if you look up, like, a... Jerry O'Connell, and like, I don't know, I'm sure now he's done the nice grade surgery, but back in the day he like has said that he got the back hair, and he's been open about it. And then other people too, you know, that Joe Buck guy, he's had like 15 hair transplant surgeries.
Joe Buck,
yeah, the announcer, the broadcaster.
Well, should I pull him up? Is he better than Jerry O'Connell?
Well, you can see how Jerry's hair is,
but now he's back at bald, and that
he's just had to do it, I think, multiple times. But Joe Buck, he almost died getting the surgery.
Seriously?
Yeah, when he went under, he like almost died. I don't know the full thing, but he did talk about it. Put in hair transplant after it. He'll talk
about him.
Good. No, I'm glad
he has a big fucking head.
This is fascinating to me. You became addicted to the hair plugs, and you said that they put
addicted
you
to the
out.
Hair
they
plugs.
Put you under for the operation.
Right.
Because you had many operations.
Yeah, I had a total of eight.
A total of eight.
Okay.
And that cuff sat on the nerve that's responsible for firing my left vocal cord. So I come out of this surgery, and I'm like,
yikes.
Yeah, is that a Peter Griffin? Yeah.
That was just a Robin.
Oh, because I was thinking Cleveland.
Oh, yeah. Yikes. Holy crap.
Holy crap, Robin.
Of course.
So anyway, but now the modern surgeries, they just take it from part of the back of your head because that's where your hair is healthiest.
Gotcha. Okay. I had no idea that you had to go back numerous times, but I love how Howard, he says you got addicted to the hair plugs like it was heroin.
So when you get a hair plug...
Dude, my hair plug bone is connected to my beer bone, which is connected to my Coke bone, which is connected to my fake tooth bone.
People should just be open about it. I think eventually they will, and then it won't matter because it's like, well, we can afford it and you can't.
Yeah.
And now you're crazy for being bald.
True. No, there needs to be openness about it, so...
People that comment take us seriously, and that is very funny to us. And we've gone through waves. Off the show, we've talked about it, and we're like, is it kind of funny if people are confused? And the answer, I think, is yes.
Yeah.
I don't know where you... I don't want to speak for you.
Here's what I will say in defense of this stuff. Okay. So a few weeks ago when we talked about this, this was the talk of the town. Every podcast is talking about this. Quiet on set! If we are your third choice of a podcast, that means you've already gone through two rounds of hearing people go, wow, the Dan Schneider thing was crazy. Dan Schneider bad. So then when it gets to us, do you really want to hear us say the exact same thing you've already heard twice? To me, that's not a show, you know? And I don't know. It's just like, that's kind of my whole takeaway is like, we're not going to say what everyone else is saying because that is retarded. Just go and watch the other show where they say the safe thing.
No, I know, but that's not really what it is because people are sorry to just... But
that's okay.
It's mostly people aren't knowing that we're joking. I mean, like this comment you have up. You're joking, right? There are 50 pics of him. It's like people can't tell that we're joking on here. And I don't know what to do about you people.
No, it is just funny to watch. I mean, they're just going to fall into it. And then this has to be satire or he's just willfully blind. We got a new one too today.
Yeah. Imagine being so like, I love Dan Schneider so much. I have to stick my neck out for him. There's no way... This guy did it. It's like nobody's upset. Like no one is defending Dan Schneider. Everybody hates him just by looking at him.
Seriously.
Even the fat activists are probably like, gross.
So this came out earlier today. Seriously, WTF are you talking about from about 7 minutes onwards? You're joking? I can't even tell if it's a bit because it's such a long
That's
play.
Actually the best compliment we could get.
I know, yeah.
Sorry, I have vape coming out of my mouth, so I've got a deeper voice.
The dragon.
I can't even tell if it's a bit because it's such a long play. If nothing else, is that not what gooning is, people? That's what really the message of the show is. This whole thing is a long play.
He's been edging this whole time and he can't tell.
I know, it's like, what are you doing? If your hand is down your pants and you're watching the show, then we've sucked you in.
Mm-hmm.
And we've sucked you off.
And we've got you thinking about us. And
sound
gooning.
Cuts out at 40-40. Whoa.
I fixed it.
Okay. Killed my goon.
I know.
Puff Dragon.
Puff Barack the Magic. We row. So we'll never stop gooning. We'll never stop with the great takes that are things that you haven't heard before. And I think that's it.
I think that's it. Could we play that outro from the Rush Limbaugh thing? The Brock has nothing to do with anything we've talked about.
Yeah.
But I don't think it'd be a bad outro.
This is a good... You could never do this today.
You could never do this today.
Oh, this because is?
Because the Young Turks were trying to say that they were... No, maybe it wasn't. There was like a big news article that was saying that people were characterizing in the Democratic Party maybe that Brock was the magic Negro. Do you know about this trope in literature? You know, like when you're going on a quest... You know that weird ass, what's that, Hodorowski movie, whatever the fuck, the mystical Sacred Mountain? Yeah, that's it. The Sacred Mountain. Remember I watched that weird trippy movie?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know how else to describe it besides trippy. At the beginning of the movie, he finds like somebody's like amputated from the waist down. And that's like his little companion. So in literature, though, there's something similar. It's the magic Negro, right? And you meet him along your journey, and he has some sort of weird, mystical voodoo advice.
Okay.
It's more common probably like in Southern literature, like, you know, down in Louisiana, the magic Negro. you know, it's like a trope. It's a character. There's a Wikipedia article about it. So somebody wrote an article saying they were doing that about Barack. That's why the guy sang it on Rush's show. And now we can't find it.
There's something humming down here. Oh, that's somebody's BlackBerry. That's Sharpton's BlackBerry.
He's such a Obama's such a white guy that it makes no sense.
I know.
When he would do that.
Well, do you remember when Kamala Harris did this in like 2020-ish?
She still kind of does it though, doesn't she? When she just randomly goes in the black woman voice.
Yeah, yeah. Like... I just remember one time, maybe it was her or Cory Booker, but during the debates, they were like, down in Louisiana where I think it was Cory Booker. He's like, where I'm from, we've got this saying. You can't put your shit in the watermelon and expect it to be with the fried chicken. Like, it was that level of, like, he literally said watermelon. It was insane.
Uh-huh.
Okay, we got to get to the song.
Obama.
I love these videos. It's fucking...
Barack the Magic Negro lives in D.C. The L.A. Times, they called him that because he's not authentic like me. Yeah, the guy from the L.A. paper said he made guilty whites feel good. They'll vote for him and not for me because he's not from the hood.